Hey there everyone, I am Rukmin Midda. So this is a task given by Mr. Vimal Daga sir under LW summer program. The task description is pull the Docker container image of CentOS from Docker Hub and create a new container, install Python software on top of Docker container, and then copy paste your machine learning code inside Docker container and train the model that we created in Jupyter Notebook. So I thought let's integrate few more things in this. So let me show you how I created the whole setup. So this is my Red Hat base OS, and in this system, if I quickly run systemctl status docker, you will see my Docker services are running. Now this is my workspace, and if I do ls, you will see there are total four files. One is build run.sh, so this is a shell script which contain two codes. One is for creating the Docker image and another is to run the Docker image. Another is my Docker file, and this is my .csv, means this is my raw data, and this is my ipynv file, means my Jupyter Notebook file. Now if I do cat on Docker file, you will see, so I'm using from CentOS. This is my CentOS image it's using as base image. It's installing Firefox and Python 36 software, then it's installing some required libraries using pip, and then work director, environmental variables and entry points. So these are normal things. And let me show you the build sh. So cat, if I run build.sh, so you will see this is a shell script, and it contains first of all docker build hyphen t jupyter hyphen centos colon version dot. So this is creating one image using docker build, using this docker file, and giving the name jupyter hyphen centos, and then it's running the container, and it's using x11 forwarding so that we can get the GUI of our Jupyter Notebook. And I mounted this my current directory. If I run pwd, you will see my current directory is /root/test. So I mounted this folder inside the same folder. So because this is my work directory, so on this directory, Jupyter Notebook will open and I will be able to access these files. And this is my container. So let me run it quickly so that I can show you how it's working. If I run, you can see the image has been built, and then it started the image, and now you will see it's working very smooth. And this is my on Firefox, this is Jupyter running on inside my container 32BD100100. So this is my container ID, and if I go to, I need to show you here, let me quickly check if I can see the container ID. So I think here container ID it's not showing, but if I go to another terminal, I can very easily show you. So and you can see those files are accessible here. And let me quickly run the ipynv file just to show you that it's working perfectly fine. So this is simple linear regression, and I run import libraries, then I created my data set, then I created x and y, then I trained the model, and then do the prediction. It's a very just simple code, linear regression, and then I save the model. So as soon as I save the model, it's saved inside my Docker container, and this is the model saved inside my Docker container. And let me just quickly close it, and now still the notebook is running. Let me stop the notebook, and as I used entry point, so automatically my container will exit. And if I now do ls, you will see one new wait file count. So this file has been trained inside my Docker container using Jupyter. And if I show you one more thing, docker ps hyphen a, you will see there are a lot of containers. But if I go to, so this is my container Jupyter hyphen centos v1. So about a minute ago, exited 0:17. So this is the container that's just created few minutes ago. And then after I completed the task, it exited. So thank you everyone for watching this video. I will again come up with one new another video.